in Word document and all. Okay, and the most important point is that we need to know what is the universal journal ledger. Okay, so for that thing, can you open the notepad? Yes. Or else open the Word document.
Can I open?
Yeah, open that Word document. Okay, see all of you, the most important point is that the Universal Journal in SAP S/4HANA is a revolutionary data model change in financial accounting and reporting. You know it very well. Basically, it's a, how we can able to define it? It's a central repository that consolidates financial and management accounting data into a single, okay. Okay, those harmonized table is, we can call it as AC DOCA, okay? Universal Journal Entry Line Items, we can call it as, basically. So this master data guide is very, very important for the Universal Journal Ledger. See all of you, I just give you one point. Ma'am, can you write down the scenario, Universal Journal Ledger scenario? Just make a side heading, that is a Universal Journal Ledger scenario. Scenario, S-E-N-A-R-I-O. See, scenario, S-E. S-E-N-A-R-I-O. So, in the past, SAP ECC Right. In the past SAP ECC, the most important point is the first point. Write down the point, ma'am. Write down the point. First point. No, no, no. Click on the enter. Make it as first point. Click on the enter. First point is SAP ECC. SAP ECC stored financial data. SAP ECC stored financial data in separate ledgers. In separate ledgers, SAP ECC stored financial data. SAP stored financial data in separate ledgers. In separate ledgers. See, which requires complex reconciliation and data synchronization, which requires requires, which requires complex reconciliation, ma'am, requires reqires. Requires, not the request. Remove the test. T-E-S-T. Ma'am, requires, ma'am. Remove the S-E-S-T. REQUIRES space reconciliation space complex reconciliation. No. After the complex, you are writing the reconciliation. RE, right? RECONCILIA. TION and data synchronization and data synchronization SYNCHRONIZATION. Okay, so then second pointer. See all of you, SAP ECC stored financial data in separate ledgers, which requires complex reconciliation and data synchronization. Okay, so those things are mandatory. See, the universal journal in SAP S/4HANA streamlines this complexity by integrating previously, separate data like the general ledger, profitability and controlling and asset accounting and material ledger and more information into the one item table with the full details of all the application. That we can call it as a universal journal ledger. Okay, universal AC Docker table. That's it, right, all of you? See, this AC Docker table is one data model, all of you. See, try to observe the point. And in SAP S/4HANA, Universal Journal Entry Line Items table is AC Docker. Can you write on the second point, ma'am? AC Docker contains, write on the second point. Yes, AC Docker contains, AC Docker, ACDOCA contains multiple fields of other tables. Multiple fields of other tables and basis for reporting. Okay, so basically AC Docker contains multiple fields, right? That means it stores all controlling internal postings which are not posted to any BSEC. Okay, we do have different types of tables. So for that tables and all, we do have one more class, okay, to explain the tables and all. Okay, so basically it stores carry forward and correction lines from S/4HANA migration and which are not stored in BSEC basically. Okay, like when it comes to the entries, some key aspects of AC Docker tables. Okay, and universal journal extensibility will be there. And what could be the universal journal extensibility and how the extensibility will be worked based on the multi-currency capabilities. Okay, so third one is multi-currency capabilities. Okay, so don't worry, all of you. I will show you the things and all. Just I am giving you the points. See, if they are asking about the universal journal ledger concept and all, you just need to speak all these points. Okay, then they will understand. Okay, this person knows everything. Multiple currency capabilities. Okay, so how many currencies will be defined basically in multiple currencies? So currencies will be defined. Okay, I think so. Multiple currencies will be defined in SAP S/4HANA. Those are 8 currencies. Okay, multiple currencies are 8. You can just put the one thing in bracket. That is 8 currencies we can able to create it. At a time, 8 currencies will be created, all of you. That we can call it as a multiple currencies. Okay, that is 8 currencies will be created. Okay, all right. So those currencies are, no. Just give the 8 currencies. Okay, no need to write anything. And MOC, that is, you know it very well, that AC Docker field name is WSL, TSL, HSL, KSL, OSL, VSL, BSL, CSL. Like this, we will have it. okay, DSL, ESL, FSL, GSL. See, when it comes to the WSL, amount in transaction currency, that we can call it as a document currency. TSL is amount in balance transaction currency. Okay, balance sheet transactions will be there in the financial statement version, so that we can call it as a transaction currencies. Okay, and amount in company code currency, local currencies will be there. Amount in global currencies also will be there. Okay, so see, whenever you open the items like FB50 transaction, okay, in the line item level, you can able to see it. Amount in document currency or amount in local currencies. Okay, you can able to find it, right? So, I mean, if you are having the foreign currency revaluation, we can call it as a global currencies. Okay, everything should be alternate with particular currency. Okay, so see, you have freely currency will be there, freely defined currencies will be there, object currencies of the particular COs will be there. Okay, multiple currencies will be handled in the one screen, that is Universal General Ledger screen. That is the most important thing right now. We have supported reporting for currency fields in SAP S/4HANA. Okay, so I mean, you can able to have the supporting currencies fields in SAP S/4HANA. You can just write down the fourth point, ma'am. The supported reporting for currency fields, the supporting, these points are very, very important, all of you. The support, the supported reporting for currency fields. Fields, okay, in S/4HANA. You can just write down the transaction codes, ma'am, in the bracket. See, in the FB03, you can able to find out the display document, then you can able to find out the currencies. And in FB03L, FB03L, see, in this FB03L, display your document in general ledger viewpoint. When it comes to the FB03, that just gives you the document, display document only based on your company code. And based on the ledger wise, you can be able to use the FB03L transaction code. And then next, FAGL B03. This FAGL B03 basically gives you display GL account balances, right? Okay, so FAGL B03 displays GL account balances, and FAGL03 displays the GL account line items also. Okay, next transaction code is FAGLL03. So displays the GL account line items only. Okay, so see, whenever you are having the free time, please try to go through the all transaction codes and give your company code details or accounting details and all. You will find out a lot of difference in EC Docker table comparing with ECC. Okay, and GL line item browser will be FAGL L03H. See, all of you, display GL accounts line items in Fiori app. Do you know about the Fiori app? SAP S/4HANA, you are seeing the normal screen, right? In the Fiori app, there could be a difference. Okay, directly whatever the details that you are entering, so it will be entered in the Fiori app only. So I will take the one class for the Fiori app. I think so on next Sunday, you are going to find a lot of details. Okay, don't worry. And what could be the general entry analyzer in the Fiori app, audit journal entry in the Fiori app? Okay, display financial statement versions in the Fiori app. Yeah, so those things are very, very important when it comes to the universal journal ledger. Okay. Now you got my point, right, all of you? See, basically, this universal journal ledger is the book of original entry for business transactions in financial accounting and also controlling, basically. And it contains the journal entries generated by these transactions and thus represents the single source of the truth in SAP S/4HANA, that is AC DOCA. Okay. But in when it comes to the ECC, every time you need to go back to the transact tables transactions and you need to enter the tables and all. But in universal journal ledger, like when it comes to the AC DOCA, okay, just in one screen, you can able to find out a lot of tables. Okay, for the tables, we do have one more session. Okay, I will going to cover it. And if you know all these things, then only your interview, you will be passed in the interview, basically. If you don't know about all these things, they just don't care about your profile, first of all. Okay, so that is the most important thing right now we have. So then next one, in universal journal ledger, if you want to see the details, okay, ledger details and all, you will use the transaction code. Fifth one is, yes, to see the universal journal ledger, JOURNAL ledger, use the transaction code FINSC_ledger. Now we are having, we are getting the error based on the universal journal ledger things and all. Okay, you can use the transaction code, that is FINSC_ledger. FINSC_ledger. LEDGER. Okay, now, yes, you can just go back to the SAP S/4HANA screen. So see, all of you, we are discussing the error with scenario. Okay, so this is the error, all of you. In real time also, every user faces this issue. Okay, that is, correct the customizing settings for the ledgers for the universal journal. Okay. So what is your ledger? You need to find out, right? So basically SAP, most of the SAP clients, they just use the journal, leading ledgers only, not the non-leading ledgers and all. See, if you are having the non-leading ledgers for reporting purposes, everything will be on reporting purposes only. All of you try to understand it. Okay, if they are using, so basically there is a reason to use it. Okay. If it is a customizing reporting, or if it is a normal reporting, or if it is a self-customized reporting and all, we can able to use it, right? Good. Okay, go back to the next screen. Take out the next screen, ma'am. Take out the next screen. And go to the transaction code, FINSC_ledger. So please use it, all of you. FINSC_ledger is FINSC_ledger, CC, not E. See, whenever you are writing one thing, please be careful about it. Okay, so click on the enter. See, this universal journal ledger entries, okay, will be maintained at transaction code FINSC_ledger. And in that thing, you will going to find out a lot of things also, all of you. Group currencies, ledgers, non-leading ledgers, appendix ledgers, okay, accounting principles. Okay, so go to the continue option. No worries. See, most of the people will do like this. Accounting principles will not be assigned to the particular company codes and all. In asset accounting, definitely you will going to find out a lot of errors, all of you. Okay, that is the most important point right now we have. See, all of you, global currencies conversion settings will be there, and currency conversion settings will be there. I will show you after clearing of all these errors and all in our company code. Okay, so this is the leading ledger, all of you. Whatever the ledgers that we have, that should not be ticked as leading ledger. Why? All these things are what? Non-leading ledger. So non-leading ledger will be assigned to the underlying ledger. That we can call it as a leading ledger for the legal evaluation purpose. See, LD means leading ledger, ledger name. Is it a leading ledger for your particular company code reporting? Yes. See, no one will going to tick mark on the any appendix ledgers or non-leading ledgers and all. Okay, so extension ledger type. See, all of you, this is the standard ledger, right? Okay, so now they are extending this standard ledger to the particular leading ledger. Now you will going to get one dot. What is ledger? Okay, what about this leading ledgers and all? See, in SAP S/4HANA Cloud, okay, leading ledger OL is always the leading ledger. OL is the always leading ledger. Okay, so this settings cannot be changed. Please be careful about this point. This settings cannot be changed, and you can, however, change the assignment of the accounting principle to the ledger by default. I mean, this is a local accounting principle, right? So that is why we will going to use this leading ledger. But the thing is that when it comes to the leading ledgers and all, whatever the things that we have created, I mean, all company codes created in SAP are automatically assigned to the leading ledger. It is recommended not to change the leading ledger, as it also integrates with other modules such as asset accounting, controlling, and logistics and all. Okay, that is very, very important. Right. So basically, in each and every company code, the leading ledger receives exactly the same settings that apply to the company code currencies. You got my point? Whatever the things that you do, I mean, in different screens or in different configurations. Okay. So those things will be applied to the company code currencies basically. Okay, physical year variant and posting periods variant, you can define a second and third party parallel currencies for your leading ledger for company code. Okay, so non-leading ledgers are parallel ledgers to the leading ledger. You got my point, right, all of you? Now, see, what is the use of this leading ledger? Okay. So this leading ledger contains all information necessary to make the postings. I mean, to make the business transactions, all information it contains basically. So it is the basis for other ledgers that might be created in addition for the other purposes. See, simple thing, all of you. It contains all necessary information to make the postings, business postings. So that is why we are using this leading ledger. And whatever the postings that you do, okay, based on that thing, we will go into based on the ledger wise. Okay, you got my point? In the GL account, control data tab, you are finding open item management by leading ledgers. I mean, open item management by ledger. What is that ledger? OL. Okay, this OL cannot be changed. Okay, you cannot make any such changes in FINSA underscore ledger. First of all, whoever is creating the non-leading ledger, this non-leading ledger or parallel ledgers to the leading ledgers only, all of you. Okay, but you make this leading ledger as an extension ledger type to your non-leading ledger. Okay, so whenever you make the transaction, it will be go back to the extension ledger group, then come back to the non-leading ledger. Okay, you are getting my points, right, all of you? So extension ledger is nothing but the non-leading ledger, and this non-leading ledgers are basically parallel to the leading ledgers. Okay, so why you need to use this leading ledger? This leading ledger contains all information necessary to make postings. That's it, right? Okay, so basically, it is the basis for the ledgers that might be created in addition for other purposes. Okay, that is the most important point in the leading ledger. And you can able to have another thing also. I mean, OL is the leading ledger and used for regular updation. Now we will go into see it. See, validation view. Ma'am, can you select this OL, leading ledger, OL, double click on company code settings for the ledger. Yes, double click on it, no issue. Yes, go to the continue option. Okay, now go to the position. Now go to the position and give the company code, your company code. Okay, see all of you. Our local currency is company code currency, that is 10. Do we have any group currencies? No. Okay, why? Because we haven't created any company code group currencies under our particular company code, right? So can you drag it to the right side? Can you drag it to the right side, ma'am? Right side. No. Below there is a right option. Drag it to the right side. Right, not the left. Right. Yeah. See all of you. How many free currencies that you can able to make? Okay, 8 free currencies you can able to make. See, this company code is having the fiscal year variant. Why you are having the fiscal year variance and all? Okay, we haven't assigned anything in FINSA underscore ledger. Okay, why you are getting all these points? Okay, see, you know it very well, right? Whatever the leading ledger receives, I mean, the leading ledger receives exactly the same settings that apply to the company codes. Is it right or not? You have assigned company code to the fiscal year variant. Then, based on the ledger, it will observe all these points. See, and the posting period variant. We have assigned posting period at one place, and now it is reflecting in the FINSA underscore ledger. That we can call it as a universal journal. Okay, whatever the changes that you make, I mean, whatever the things that you do, okay, it will be gathered in FINSA underscore ledger. And accounting principle, okay. What is the accounting principle? What is the accounting principle, all of you? General accepted accounting principle, which is generated by the SAP system. Okay, everyone will going to use the accounting principle as GAAP, but I will show you when it comes to the foreign currency revaluation as well as in asset accounting configurations also, I will show you how we can able to create the accounting principles and will be applied to the particular universal journal ledger. Why you are not having the parallel GL accounts? This is not an extensional GL ledger, right? So that is why you're not having the parallel GL accounts. Drag it to the right side. Drag it to the right side, ma'am. drag it to the right side. See, what is the functional currency? See, you know it very well. So first FI currency is 10. Second FI currency, third FI currency. So yeah, so many currencies are there. Okay, all of you. So defaultly 8 currencies are available for your company code. Okay. So I mean, when it comes to the foreign currency revaluation, we will try to create the GBR currencies, USD currencies, and Canada currencies, and UK currencies. Every currency we will go into create it and will be updated automatically in the Universal General Ledger concept. This is the most important scenario. They will just ask you, what do you mean by ledger, leading ledger, non-leading ledger? Okay, so why you are using the extensional ledger with the help of your standard ledgers and all? Okay, so I mean, non-leading ledgers are parallel ledgers to the leading ledger. That's it. For reporting purposes only, we can able to use it. Okay, without leading ledger, you cannot do any operations, all of you. So that is the 100% thing. Okay, so now what we need to do, so this is the ledger concept. I mean, I will explain you in upcoming classes in a detailed manner. The thing is that you are getting the error, that is universal journal error. Okay, so now we go back to the FB50 transaction code. Okay, go back to the FB50 transaction code, ma'am, and try to open the errors. How many errors that we are finding here in FB50? Can you open this select the customizing settings for ledgers, for universal ledger? Okay, so from our side, the parameters are very much fine. Open that thing. Now check the customizing settings using transaction FINS_custom_CONS_CHK_P. See, from our side, that is fine. That is FINS_CUST_CONS_CHK. That means, see, our posting period is variant is assigned to the company code. You have seen it. And fiscal year variant is assigned to the particular company code. You have seen it. And accounting principle is also assigned to the particular company code. You have seen it. Then what could be the errors? Okay, that is universal general errors. Okay, why? Because leading ledger is already assigned to the all company codes. Then automatically in demo server also you will going to get it. And real time, I think so. We have faced it one point, that is cost objective points and all. We have faced this error only. And certainly we have closed it based on our company codes. But it's a demo server, right? So it takes a lot of time to clear that error. But once you clear that error, you are not going to face a thing in this company code. Okay. You do one thing, open this FINSCUST_CONS_P. Select that thing, ma'am. The system will going to show you the errors. Select the FINS_CUST_CONS_. See, all of you. Company code ledger MAL2, everything is fine. Okay, so there is a errors. Okay, come down, ma'am, down, come down. Or else you can able to select these things like errors things and all. 60 errors will be there. Okay. Down. Yes. All right, see all of you, we are having all these errors. Okay, for posting period is variant is empty, ledger Y4, company code MAL2, and posting period variant is empty, ledger Y5, Sorry, yeah, Wi-Fi company code MAL2. So is it related to our company code address? No, right? So what you need to do is come back, ma'am. I will show you. Come back. Yes. So select your FINS underscore CUST underscore CONS underscore CHK only. Okay. See, wait for 1 minute. So if this message was displayed during a posting activity, use this transaction code. Okay. So, but we are posting the transaction, right? So in this customizing transactions, we need to have the things. Okay. So we do have different types of errors like gap and go up. $162 accounting principal GAAP and 0001 assigned in leading ledger company code. Okay. We cannot able to create, we cannot able to give, or solve the 15,252 errors. Okay. This is not our company code. This is not our company code. Come down, ma'am. We are, searching for each and every company code. Then we go back to the FINSE underscore, CUST underscore CHK underscore P. Okay. Come down, down. MRF. MRF MAL2. Okay, our company code is not there. First check with all these things, all of you. If our company code is there, okay, so we need to solve these errors. If our company code is not there, okay, we can go back to the our own errors. Okay, you got my point, right, all of you? Definitely you will not going to have any errors in the customizing request. Come back, no issue. You just open the FINS underscore CUST underscore CHK underscore P. Yes. Can you select this thing, ma'am? There is 60 errors. Go up. There is a red color mark 60. Select it. Select it once again. Or else select the 59. Select the 59. And select the warning message one. Now select the 60. That is 60 errors. This, yes. Give me 1 second. Posting period is variant variant is empty ledger AB company code MAL2. You do one thing. Go back to that screen, ma'am. AB, AC, AD. No, don't do it. Go back to that screen. FINSE underscore ledger. Now see, all of you, by default things only. Okay, every time, so the ledger AB is the ledger. Okay, in that ledger, okay, we are finding now. Come back to this screen. Show me that thing error. No, ma'am. Come back to the screen. When I am saying come back to the screen, that means if you are in one screen, you can come back to that screen. No. Just be there. A posting period variant. This posting period is variant is empty for ledger in company code MAL2. See, all of you, this is the universal journal ledger. Okay. And leading ledger is the fine thing for our reference. But number of things will be there. This is the demo system, right? But in real time, you're not going to face any errors. You just face one error, that is ledger error. That posting period is not assigned to the OL only. Now it is a demo server, right? And that means everybody is having the access. Whoever is creating the ledgers, our company code will be assigned to that particular ledgers only. Okay. This is a demo server. So that's why we are getting a lot of errors. But in real time, okay, you just face one error, that is OL, OL only. You got my point, right, all of you? Now, so to clear this error, what we need to do, so go back to the screen, ma'am, FINSE underscore ledger, and select the AB ledger, and the posting period is empty for our company code. Select this ledger, double click on ledger, left side ledger is there, right? Double click on ledger. Your posting period variant is what? What is the posting period variant? MAPZ. Okay. Double click on ledger. Yes. Continue it. Continue it. And see, AB is the representative ledger. Okay, see, and this underlying with zero L. So that is why we are getting the error. Select AB ledger, and double click on company code settings for the ledger. Double click on company code settings for the ledger. Continue it. Select your position and go to the company code. Give your company code. Continue it. Drag it to the right side. Posting period variant is empty. Okay, just give it MA. What is that posting period? MAPZ. Click on the enter, go to the save button and save it. No need to have any accounting principle. Why? Because this is not our standardized ledger, right? See, underlying ledger is OL. So that is why this OL is particularly assigned to the company code MAL2, right? Okay. So this is having extension ledgers. I mean, this OL is having different types of extension ledgers. Why? Because it's a demo server, right? Everyone will going to create it for their reference. Okay, so that is not at all good for themselves also, but they don't even know, right? What is the extension ledger? What is the leading ledger and all? Continue it. So continue it. No need to have any customizing request and all. Continue. Okay, good. So now one error is cleared. Then go back to the ledger, ma'am. Double click on ledger once again. In the ledger here on. AB is done and AC, AD, AE. Ledger. Continue. AB, AC, AC, AC. Double click on company code settings for the ledger. See, all of you are getting, I mean, definitely you get different types of doubts. See, our ledger is 0L and OL. Why you are getting errors for the extension ledgers? Why? Because this leading ledger is an underlying ledger for the different types of ledgers. Okay, so assign the posting period variant. No. Go back to that screen. We do have a lot of errors. We have a lot of errors. We need to clear it. Save it. Save the details. It will take a lot of time, all of you. To clear these all errors. But the thing is that once you are familiar with all these things, so you can able to do it. Okay, so go to that continue option. AB AC is done and AD AE is there. AD, AE, a lot of things are there, right? We need to. Go back to the ledger. No. We know it, right? AD, AE, AHAS. I will tell you. Now AD. Select the AD, go to the company code settings for the ledger. We have to do it. Why? Because it's a demo server, right, all of you? Drag it to the right side. Assign the posting period variant. So AD is also done, right? AE. AE, AS, AH also we have to do it. Why? Because leading ledger is an underlying ledger for the extension ledgers. I mean, non-leading ledgers. See, all of you, if you don't use all these parameters, okay, definitely you're going to get a doubt. No. Double click on ledger. Continue it. Select AE. Yes. AE. Double click on company code settings for the ledger. Continue it. Position. See, why I am getting the error, you should know it. I mean, why you are getting all these errors, you should know the point. Okay, so simply if you, what are the errors that you have faced? If they ask you, what are the errors that you have faced? You just say that simply, these are the errors for all these ledgers. I am getting the error and all, you will going to say it. See, they will going to ask you one thing. If it is a leading ledger, why you are getting all these errors? Okay, so extension ledger will be the extension ledger will be having the underlying ledger, that is leading ledger only, right? Continue it. Go to the ledger, then next AH, after that AS. Select AH. A is done, right? Then AH, company code settings for the ledger. That's it. Continue it. Go to the position and company code. Continue it. Drag it to the right side. And posting period variant. MA PZ. Yes. Click on the enter, go to the save button and set. Then AH is done, right? AS. AH is done, right? AS. It takes some time, all of you. So be patient. In SAP FICO, you should have patience as well as enthusiasm, as well as determination, as well as precision. Okay, I mean precision is very, very important. AS. No. AS, ma'am. I think so. AI is not there. Artificial intelligence. Okay, double click on company code settings for the ledger and continue it. Drag it to the right side. Go to the position and give the company code and drag it to the right side. And posting period variant is empty. Go to the save button and save it. See, all of you, you are not going to face, these scenarios in any other Googles and all. Okay, don't Google it. just do your clear your errors by your own way. Okay, don't just depend on Google. First you should know the concept, then you can able to clear the errors. If you don't know the concept, how you can able to clear the errors? I mean, client will ask you number of questions. Why you are using extension ledger? Why you are not using leading ledger? Okay, why you are not using underlying ledger? Why you are using extension ledgers? Okay, why you are not using group currencies? They see, these are the client interviews questions. You should be very much familiar with them. No, ma'am. Go back to that screen. That is FB50 screen. AB, AC, AD, AE, AH, AS is done. AY. AY, BA, BN. Okay. AY, BA, BN, and C1, C2. AY. Go to the company code settings for the ledger. Continue it. Go to the position. Continue it. Give the posting period variant. See, most of the people will not going to understand why I am getting the error. It is not at all my ledger. Why? Because you are having the leading ledger, and that is an underlying ledger for all the extension ledgers. That is why you are getting the errors. Or else, yesterday in ECC, you have done FB50 posting within 1 minute. Now it is taking 45 minutes of time to post the to clear the errors and to post the transactions. So that is why you need to have more clarity on what you are doing. AY is done, right? Then BA. BA, BN, C1, C2. Do it. Go to the save button and save it. Then BA is done, right? Then BN. So many persons are doing the mistakes. 15,603 warning messages are there. Don't do the mistakes. Do the mistakes, no issue. But try to know what is the exact backing value that is having. BN, NN, not M. Give the posting period variant. Go to the save button and save it. That's it. After the BN, C1, C2. We need to clear a lot of errors, all of you. Go to the C1 ledger, come down. C1 ledger is there. See, all of you, no one will going to know why we are using the ledgers and all. based on the underlying ledgers and all. Okay, they don't even know the meaning of all these things, and they come back to these screens and they do it. Okay, so I mean, trainers should give the awareness of all these universal journal ledger concept and all. But in most of the markets, I mean, most of the market in marketing things and all, like training sessions and all, they just give the training on SAP ECC, not in SAP S/4HANA. Okay, it will take a lot of time to clear the errors and all. Okay, but the thing is that when you know the real-time knowledge, it will be easy for you. Okay, and the thing is that you know the definitely that interviewer should be in a position to know what is the exact configuration that is required for universal journal ledger, and it should be coming from your side only. Even though they don't know anything about ledgers after C2, C2 is done, right? Go to the C2. Okay, then come back to the screen, ma'am. What are the different types of things that we have? It will going to save it. Come back to the screen. C1, C2 is done. CC, D2, D3, DE, DM. We have to do it. C1, C2 is done. C2, D2, D3, DE. Ah, yes. Go back to the screen. CC, come on. CC is there. Select that thing. We do one thing, all of you. Now all these errors are cleared or not, we have to check it out. Otherwise we follow another method. Okay, go to the position and give the posting period variant. So we have 60 errors, right, till now, and we have changed somewhat configurations, right? Now we will go into see it once again in the FB50 transaction code only. Go back to the FB50 transaction code, ma'am. Go back to the FB50 transaction code. It will going to save it. No issue. Go back to this FB50 transaction code. No. Go back to the FB50 transaction screen, I'm saying. Okay, now you should do it. FB50. No, you are in that screen only. Close it. First, close the screen. This screen, ma'am. Errors screen are there, right? Close it, give slash in. Now enter a document date. Take it, Namish. No, give backspace. In your laptop, you can just click on the backspace. Automatically, accounts will coming into the picture. In your laptop keyboard, backspace is there, right? Just click on it. 400, 200. Take it. This is debit and amount and credit amount. Whenever you do something, right, all of you, when you click on the backspace, all entries will coming into the picture. Credit 50,000. Click on the enter and give the text. Go to the save button. Open this correct the customizing ledgers. Open it. And open that thing. FINSC custom C1 underscore P. P, P, P. No. Not this. Yes. That thing. So only 48 errors are there. You got my point, right, all of you? Previous thing 60 errors are there. Now it has been reduced to 48 errors. Okay, come down. We will going to see it. Down. D2, D3. Wait a minute. Go up. Up, not down, up. Wait a minute. Give me 1 second. D2, D3, and DE, and DM, and E6. And EE, ER, G1, GM, GO. Okay, ma'am, go back to that screen. No issue. Now do it for D2. See, all of you, you can delete the ledger also. There is no issue. Do you want to delete the ledger? Or you do one thing. Go to the delete option, ma'am. You do one thing. We will do one thing. Go to the D2. Ledger option, D2. Come back, no issue. Continue it. Select D2. How many? D2, D3, DE. D2, D3, DE. Go to the delete option. All entries. Continue it, Mahesh. Continue it. It takes some time, all of you. No issue. You can able to delete it either. Why? Because it is not our ledger, right? Number of dependent entries will be deleted. Now, continue it. Continue. Now go back to the FB50 transaction screen. No, FB50. And once again, post the FB50 transaction, ma'am. Close it. No. First, close that thing. Close the FB50 transaction screen. This screen, that screen only. Close it. FB50. I mean, if you get errors like this, okay, all of you, do it like this, okay? Why? Because your ledger is not a that ledger, right? Your ledger is only leading ledger. That's it. Here, give the text rent. Come back. Save it directly. You can save it. Nice. Go to the customizing ledger once again. Go to the P. Again, 48 entries. Come down. Down. D2, D3, DE, why it is not saved? Go back to the customizing ledger. I mean, FINSE_C. Go back to the FINSE ledger. D1 and D2. And do one thing, give slash n. Come back to the transaction FINSE_ledger. Give slash n, FINSE_ledger. Continue it, ma'am. Come down. Down. See, these ledgers are not deleted. Why? Why all of you? Okay, do it. These are in legal valuation, right? See, if I say anything, just think it. Okay, but why it will be deleted? It is not created by you. Okay, why it will be deleted? Okay, don't worry. Go to the D2, D2, D3. Do it fast, ma'am. Company code settings for the general ledger. Ledger. If it is not created by you, how you can able to delete it? Think it, all of you. You should raise a question to me. How it will be deleted? Okay. Save it.
Next one is D3. Okay, so that is done, right? DEDM.
What entries are there? After the DM, E6. E6, ER, G1. We do have a lot of errors. No, 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 no. Don't do all these things, ma'am. Why you're doing with KP ledger, KR ledgers and all. Sorry, year ledger, right? Year is done, right? Then G1, GM. Then G1 and GM. Takes a lot of time, all of you. I think so, all of you. I mean, in your servers, you will not going to get these errors. I think so, you will going to get 5 to 6 or 9 or 10 errors only. Why? Because where you have taken this server, ma'am? Have you taken this server from where? Babu only? Okay, okay, do it, do it, do it. After the G1, GM, GO. G1, GM, GO, 7, it's 9, 10. After GM, you do have GO. And we do have another address also. That is ledger SX is not an extension ledger. You cannot assign an underlying ledger. And ledger TC is not an extension ledger. You cannot assign an underlying ledger. And we need to change it, all these things. After GM, GO. How many errors are left, ma'am? Can you open that screen? Come down. No, 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 no. Here, here only. After GO. GO. Come down. Down. Oh, lot of errors are there. Ma'am, you do one thing. Assign posting variant to each and every general ledger. I will show you how we can able to see the, go to that screen, ma'am. FB50 screen. Go up. There is a error. Go up. Complete up. Go up, complete up. So ledger, no, come down, no. Errors you have to see me. Ledger SX is not an extension ledger TC. Go back to that screen, ma'am. Go to the SX. And we need to change it as an extension ledger. Double click on ledger. Go to the position and take out SX ledger. SX. Continue it. See here, all of you. He is making this ledger as a standard ledger. Okay, that is not at all good. This is extension ledger. Everyone is doing like this. Extension ledger. Yes. Keep it as extension ledger. Go. And TC. TC is also extension ledger. Why? Because they haven't assigned any underlying ledger, right? So that is why we are getting the errors. Go to the save button and save it. Save it. Now go back to the FB50 transaction screen, ma'am. Come back to the FB50 screen, Manish. Give slash n, ma'am. Again, give FB50. Now we will going to see it whether these extension ledgers errors have been removed or not from this FB50 screen. Open the correct customizer settings for ledger. Open it. See, 38 errors are there only, and you need to make 38 entries right now. Okay, come down. See, extension ledgers have been removed, okay, from this screen. Only EEGOHE. Ma'am, you do one thing, ma'am. So please assign the posting period variant to the particular ledger based on our company code. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So try to show me the entry after clearing of all these errors. Try to post entry. You know it very well, right? How to take the screenshot and all and post it in the chat box. Everybody is clear with the scenario, right? All of you. Do you have any doubts?
Remaining 38 ledgers also I will assign to the our company code.
If you assign a posting period variant to the company code based on the ledger and all, definitely you will not going to face any errors in upcoming sessions also.
Okay, sir. I will do it, sir.
Anybody is having the doubt? All of you. See, when I ask you one question, please say whether it is yes or no. If you don't have any doubt, say no.
Sir, another posting period also we are taking to the extension and the standard level, sir. Why you are talking to other posting period variants, sir? This one.
Didn't understand your question, ma'am.
Here also, This is not our relevant to the posting periods. This one.
That's why I'm saying, so from past 40 minutes only, I'm saying that if it is particularly assigned to the leading ledger as an underlying ledger, okay, so this extension ledger is assigned to the underlying ledger, that is OL, and that OL is particularly assigned to the our company code.
Okay, sir.
That is where you are getting the errors. In real time, it will not be like that. Okay, ledgers, you are not going to face so many ledgers like this. These are the user-defined ledgers. They don't even know what is the extension ledger and underlying ledger and all. Okay. So okay, that is why they are creating, and based on that underlying ledger, they are giving. You can able to have the non-leading ledger for reporting purposes, but why you are creating? Whenever you are having the high qualified leading ledgers and all, why you are go for the extension ledgers? That is no issue. But the thing is that make 38 entries, ma'am.
Yes, sir.
Show me the output in the chat box. Okay.
Okay, sir. Sure, I will do it, sir.
Okay, all of you. I think so. Why? Because it is, taking too much of time. That is why. I will stop this recording, all of you, and do it with right.